really interesting to hear. You know, when workshops or seminars like this come up and people come with very eloquent speech aggregated points
and
brilliant ideas, why everybody claps and all of that. Mm-hmm. And then when everybody goes home, It's back to the normal.
Yes, that is until the next year.
Until the next year, or until the next seminar, mm-hmm. or the next workshop.
Yeah, now, which makes you want to even ask the question. Since 85, the Beijing conference of 85. 85. There was the 85 one.
But the most popular one was 95.
The one that talked about, you know, 35% affirmative action and all of that, that women
should
be.
The one that Miriam Abacha went and came back, it was 95.
Wasn't
it? It was 1995. Ah. 1985 was still Buhari and IBB.
Anyhow, there was a Beijing conference, right, that decided that 35% affirmative action, 35% should be given to women. Mm. How much progress have we made since that declaration?
Now, the point there is, that question should have been directed to women to say, okay, let us ensure that we take 35%, not waiting for anyone to give them 35%. That is the issue. But we have joining us now the vice presidential candidate of the Young Progressives Party, Uma Getso. Good morning. It's good to have you join us this morning.
Okay.
Uma, it's good to have you join us. Let me ask you this morning. I know you have heard so much about inadequate participation or the rate of or the level of participation of women in politics. Here you are, the vice presidential candidate of the Young Progressives Party. Talk to us about your passion and how strong you feel about being the vice presidential candidate of a political party at this time.
Well, I'm so very passionate about politics from the word go. This is a dream that's happened to me all my life. And being a running mate to especially the hope Nigeria have today, Professor Kingsley Magalu, is really a kind of a drive that I have that and it's a kind of fulfilling. Because I'm very sure this is a kind of chance that's given to women to come and be fully engaged and give their maximum to the political arena.
Yeah, but the problem seems to be that women wait to be given. I mean, you just made that statement now. How about women actually going for it? What do you think is or are the impediments in the way of women actually attaining even the highest level of political, ambition? The presidency, for example, you are a running mate, a vice presidential candidate. In many states, the women are usually the deputy, governorship candidates and all of that. What is stopping the woman from going for the highest level?
Well, actually, in this very difficult world of women always coming to the second class. I think this, myself being the vice presidential candidate, is a kind of signal that will change the whole scenario with time. As I am here today, I am willing to see another woman or myself being on the presidential seat tomorrow. So this is a very good start for women, though there are a lot of factors like social, economic, and religious, and political and kind of social and cultural factors that are stopping women from achieving this dream. But I'm very sure at this time, women, Nigeria is very, very ready to have women in the system.
All right, talk to us. Your party, as the name is, Young Progressives Party, it certainly has to do with a lot of young people, although not restricted to young people like I was made to understand. But talk to us about your program. So you are going in as a vice presidential candidate, as a woman. So you have a lot of peculiarities, good positive peculiarities on your table. How are you engaging with women on one hand and young people on the other hand as a vice presidential candidate?
Well, number one, let me address something. Young Progressive Party, it's not only about young people. We're talking of people that are young in young at heart, people that have Nigeria at heart, people that believe in a new Nigeria and a kind of paradigm shift We're looking at a new bridge of politicians coming into the run. So we are not restricting ourselves. We are not being only for young people. We are for all Nigerians. Mm.
And what Nigerians, a lot of people now will be wondering exactly what Umar Getso has to bring to the table. Coming to your level on a personal level now as the vice presidential candidate, what impact do you think you'll be making to a YPP presidency?
Well, as well known to everyone that knows Umar Getso in person, Umar Getso has been a kind of child education, girls' child education activist. And actually, I've been a person that I've always put the interests of the youth and women and the general development of our public at heart. So this, I'm very sure this opportunity has given to me by the grace of God is going to change the scenario. Because women, actually, they have a lot of challenges, like hospitals, like a kind of the high death rate, in the hospitals, actually, we are women, we're the ones that are at sick. So myself being here, because I'm directly involved, because I'm a mother, I'm a wife, and I'm a mother to all the people. So I know our problem, and I'm very sure I will add a lot of value to this whole journey by the grace of God.
Are you prepared to actually stand in as president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria if the need arises?
Very, very well. Because this is a kind of dream that's been with me for a very, very long time. So now being here has given me a chance to know that, yeah, I can stand there tomorrow by God's grace.
All right, we look forward to a positive time ahead. Now, there are so many political parties, not just the Young Progressives Party. What programs does the Young Progressives Party promise to offer Nigerians that will make them look the way of YPP instead of APC or PDP or ABGA or any other SDP or any other political party?
Well, I'm very well sure that each and every Nigerian knows that Professor Kingsley Magalu stands as a kind of option, an immediate option that Nigerians need today, because he has already have his own blueprint to make a better Nigeria tomorrow, because he has already centered himself in the constitutional restructuring, economy, governance, gender equity, power reform, youth empowerment, education, innovation. That's general gravity.
Okay, let's look at the issue of corruption in Nigeria. Corruption has been a major problem for us in this part of the world. And women like yourself, they have not necessarily been above board when it comes to the issue of corruption. There's a long list of women who have found themselves fingered, you know, in public office that I would not bother to name them now. But how will YPP actually tackle the issue of corruption?
Well, just because one person or some few men that are given this opportunity have done something like they're getting themselves involved in such kind of things, doesn't mean that all women are the same. Because as a woman, we are very, very good support, and we are the person that are so very sensitive, because we believe in building, we preserve lives. So I'm very sure, even when it comes to even the nature of woman, you know, a lot of women doesn't believe in like all this, like going through the window to do a lot of such things, especially the corruption of a thing. So YPP, even in our own constitution, you see that it's a party that have already tackled all those problems, and Professor Kingsley Magalu has already set his own face, which I'm very sure he's going to tell Nigerians what he has or the plans he has for the corruption of it. And that's the actual fighting of corruption, not only on paper or on social media, but he really has his own plan on how to tackle corruption in a very, very innovative way.
All right. I want to believe you are a member of the team, and whatever programs he has is also the program you are privy to, because you must have come up with all of those plans together. Now, you said earlier on that you are an advocate of women and the part of the country where you come from too. When we talk about girl child education, it's on record that Nigeria now has close to about 13, from the latest record, we have 13 million children
out of school
mm-hmm. in Nigeria. And a chunk of that percentage is in the northern part where you come from. What plan do you have for the girl child, particularly the girl child education?
Well, actually, we are going to put a lot of weight. We plan to put a lot of weight in the girls' child education sector. Hopefully, we're thinking of creating a kind of program that will directly get children in school and give them all the necessary support to see that they have reached where they're supposed to reach, so that in order to reduce the population of girls that are out of school today.
Well, what are the specific things you would want to put in place, you know, to improve the lot of the girl child, especially in the north?
Well, I think the main thing is we are thinking of giving a kind of free education to girls. Yeah, free, a kind of, when we say free education, it starts from the even primary school level up to the tertiary institutions.
Mm. But you know that many parents now in the north are not too confident sending their girl, child to school.
Yeah, because of
security challenges. They've been at the receiving end of abductions and all of that. There's Chibok, there's Dapchi, and so many others, you know, that have even gone unreported. How will you build their confidence again that they can actually send their kids, their daughters, to school?
When, by the grace of God, if we provide a very good security system for the country, this issue of even insecurity in schools will not even arise, because if the whole nation is secured, everybody will be very, very confident to sell their children to school.
All right, just this question before we let you go. We know that you have sat down and looked at Nigeria as a whole, and you're wanting to come out to take the presidency or leadership of Nigeria is because you're not comfortable with the way things are going. What would you like to see change in Nigeria or about Nigeria, if you have to summarize in that way?
What Nigeria needs right now is a paradigm shift. We need to change the whole of the scenario things are going on. We need to compare ourselves with the international, with the Western world, because we are up to that standard. We have all the resources. So it's high time Nigerians come together to understand that we deserve each and every right, every citizen or in every world or in every country deserves. So Nigerians just need to come together, or we need to come together to understand that it's time to make things work this time around.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Uma Ghetto, the vice presidential candidate of the Young Progressives Party. Thank you for talking to us this morning.